Hey guys, my name is Kayanche and welcome to episode 8 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. In this episode, we'll be talking about how you're able to autocraft using items that don't get used up in a recipe, like, for example, buckets. So let's get started. So, pretty much like always, I got myself another demonstration world set up right here, just to give you guys a feel on how you can actually implement this in your own Logistics Pipes network. So, let's quickly run by what I set up. So first of all, of course, the creative energy cell with some power running into this logistics power junction, powering this network. Basic pipes right there, one right there. Then right here, another chassis pipe set up to both have a provider and item sink. So this is pretty much the default route for any normal stored items. A chest right here that is linked to a request pipe, so I can request things from this network, both from this chest and auto crafting. And then right here, I got myself two logistics crafting tables set up. One with the recipe for strawberry juice, as I actually had a request for that, so here you go. And one that is a recipe that uses up the liquid inside the bucket, but not the actual bucket itself. So, yes, let's quickly demonstrate how this will work. So first of all, I'll start with the juicer. The juicer is, on its own, pretty simple. As you can see right here, the recipe that I've set up is one strawberry, and a juicer will give you one strawberry juice. Makes quite some sense. Though the recipe, or the juicer in this recipe, is not used up when crafting. So, to set this up, it is quite easy. Just set up the recipe like you would normal. So, one strawberry, one juicer, and this will fill out its own. Add a crafting logistics pipe to it, right-click it with a wrench, and hit import. This is the recipe you will see then. Because it doesn't use up the juicer, what you can do is simply remove the juicer from this recipe, so left click to remove it, and make sure you have a juicer in this table, preferably just in these designated slots, as you can see right here, it's ghosted, just put it in there. So pretty much what this recipe will think, like, okay, I only need one strawberry to get one strawberry juice, put it in here, it already has the juicer, and then it will take out the strawberry juice. Let's quickly demonstrate for you guys, so request logistics pipe. Strawberry juice, let's say 10 or so. Press successful. As you can see, it is successfully crafting the strawberry juice and of course not using up the juicer. It does sometimes mess up the recipe or at least the location of this, but that's no big deal of course. It doesn't really have to be in that designated slot. So yes, that is pretty cool. The next up is a recipe that uses things like a water bucket. Like I already showed you, I got myself the chiseled waterstone recipe set up here, which is 8 vanilla stone and a water bucket. And of course, on the crafting logistics pipe, I set up the 8 stone and a bucket. This is a little bit more tricky than the other recipe, as this does actually use up the water in this bucket, but it gives you back an empty bucket. So for that, I had to set up something a little bit different. What I did is I attached another logistics chassis pipe Mark 1 in here. I could have used a Mark 2 with a crafting cart, but just for you know, demonstration's sake, I decided to use this route. I added an advanced extractor pipe or a cart in this, it can be any type. And I set it to take out empty buckets. Let me quickly set this to exclude, so you can see it won't take it out in a minute. Then again, like I already showed you, the recipe is in here. And then right here, I got myself some water buckets and some stone set up. So if I were to, for example, craft myself 8 of this stone, you would see it used up one water bucket and some stone. It's setting the stone... Oops, that did not go as planned. I forgot it will automatically take out the stone. Oops. I need to make sure to set it to include, otherwise I will derp up quite badly. Sorry for that. let me quickly do this again. So, 8 water stone. As you can see, the water stone is requested. It is crafting a... it is sending the 8 water stone in here. Because the bucket is left in here, I have the request... the chassis pipe with the extractor to take it out again. It will have to find a location in your network to actually put it. So again, this is the default route for storage in this network, this chest. So it has placed it in this chest. Pretty cool. And then of course you can attach something like an automatic bucket filler system or whatever. Pretty much your imagination is the limit. If you want to see something like an automatic bucket filler, let me know in the comment section below. Might be a cool idea if you guys are interested in something like that. And of course, this works with bigger recipes too. So let's say I use up the remaining two buckets, 16 waterstone. As you can see, it has two empty buckets that it's sending back to this chest. And of course, the waterstone is sent to the request chest. Pretty awesome. So like always, guys, I definitely hope you guys found it educational, this video. Be sure to subscribe, comment, and like this video if you are interested in doing so. And if you have any suggestions, feel free to let me know down below, because I read all my comments and suggestions, because that's what makes this series great: your questions and my knowledge on this subject. Thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.